It's a sign of the times. For the first time in decades, the U.S. beaten out of the number one spot in the global economy.
China surpassing the United States, becoming the largest in the world. So what does this say about our country's slow growth?
Joining us now, host of Sunday Morning Futures, our friend Maria Bartiromo. Maria, thanks a lot for coming on.
Hi, guys. Good to see you.
So this number is ominous. Is it as bad as it sounds?
Well, you know, people were expecting China to overtake the U.S. as the largest economy for a long time now. Let's not forget, we're talking about 1.3 billion people versus 300 million in the U.S. When you look at it straight on, I don't think you're talking about apples versus apples, because the average Chinese person makes a lot less in terms of per capita than in the average person in America. I mean, you're talking about salaries that are so much lower. So you can't really look straight on apples to apples. Having said that, this is a story about growth. And the U.S. growth is really stagnant. We are not going anywhere fast. And China's economy is growing at about 7% a year. We're growing at about 2%. So no surprise that China has become the largest economy. But there are subtleties that really make you look at measure. The measurements are different. So I'm not concerned about it. But I am concerned about the stagnant growth in the U.S. We really need to pick things up if we want to see job creation.
Well, of course, just losing the title is a blow to the ego. But what are the tangible repercussions of this?
Well, that's the thing. There's really not that many major repercussions. I mean, you're talking about the Chinese economy in terms of the sum of goods and services produced and sold, $17.6 trillion versus the U.S. at $17.5 trillion. So, I mean, a couple hundred billion dollars between friends, I guess, you know, but still the Chinese economy will continue to get larger. They are making a transition right now from becoming an export economy, producing all the products to the world, to a consumer economy, which is, of course, what we are in the U.S., a consumer economy. That's going to be tough. So again, I think the Chinese economy will continue to get larger, and the U.S., it really needs to pick up growth in order to impact its people, and that means job creation, and that's been very slow. We need a change in policies, and we need real job creating policies.
How does that affect confidence in this economy when people see a number like that and see that we've been surpassed? I know that we had better than anticipated job numbers in terms of actual rates of people's salaries increasing as well. But what does that mean?
I think that's what you hit on, and I think that's what you're hitting on as well, Anna, and that is confidence. You know, you really want to feel like you're in an economy that can produce jobs, that can grow quickly, and we're not there right now, actually. We did have a pretty good jobs number on Friday, but even there, people are poking holes because of the participation rate, because people have stopped looking. I think it is all about confidence, and that's really what we're dealing with. We're dealing with a loss of confidence in institutions, in the administration, in the economy in general, and at the same time, the Chinese economy is just, you know, spurring along and growing and doing quite well.
Your show follows us in just a few minutes. Who's on?
Well, we've got Senator John McCain coming on. Of course, he's going to be the chairman of the Senate Armed Services Committee, likely, when the new Congress takes effect. We're going to get his take on the new defense secretary, also the foreign policy of America as well. What does the huge drop in oil prices mean for our relationships? And you look at a couple of cities around the country now, we're below $2 a gallon on gasoline. So John McCain talks a lot. We're going to have a long conversation with him. And then we've got Julian Robertson on, really a legend in the finance business. He's the founder of Tiger Management. And of course, we had those blowout numbers on jobs on Friday. Talk about the economy and whether or not now is the time to put your money in the stock market for your retirement, even though we're at record levels.
Thank you, Maria. We'll be watching.
Thank you so
Thanks
much
for being here.